Welcome to another episode. In this episode, we're going to examine planets Mercury and Venus. These planets are either always following the Sun at sunset or moving ahead of the Sun at sunrise. Because of this, these planets are always quite difficult to see. As you can see in this footage, Venus becomes visible just as the Sun sets. While you can try and capture Venus and Mercury during the day, I don't recommend this as you can accidentally look at the Sun unless you know what you're doing. Unfortunately, neither Venus nor Mercury will show much detail on their disk, especially as Venus is covered in a thick cloud layer. However, I have managed to capture the clouds of Venus and the shades of Venus, as shown in this linked video. As you can see in this video, Venus is showing a crescent phase. However, you'll never see a full disk of Venus, nor will you see a new Venus. This is because, as you can see this animation here, when the full disk of Venus will be visible to Earth, the Venus will actually be behind the Sun, and when the new phase of Venus will be visible to Earth, Venus will be directly in front of the Sun. And so in both instances, Venus is impossible to see. Of course, the same rules apply to Mercury and any comets that happen to go inside the Earth's orbit. So at that point, they become inferior to us in the solar system. In a lot of respects, due to the inferior planet's position compared to the Earth, those inferior planets are a lot more difficult to see compared to the superior planet. Because of this, there are a few concepts that you need to get your head around if you want to see the inferior planets well. First is the greatest eastern elongation. This is the greatest height and altitude that the planet will appear before the Sun rises in the eastern sky. The maximum eastern elongation is the best time to see Mercury or Venus in the morning sky. The next concept is the superior conjunction. This is when the inferior planet is behind the Sun, and so therefore impossible to see from the Earth. Next is the maximum western elongation, and this is the opposite of the maximum eastern elongation, in that that is the maximum distance above the horizon in the western sky, so when the Sun is setting. It's the best time to see the inferior planet at sunset. The next concept to get your head around is the inferior conjunction. This is when the inferior planet crosses the disk of the Sun and is therefore invisible from Earth. However, it can be seen in rare circumstances when planets line up just right so the transits can be seen from the Earth. This happened recently in 2019, and here is a link to the video. These are quite rare events, however, a Mercurian transit is more common than a Venusian transit. That happens about every 100 years or so. As you can see in this footage of Mercury transiting the Sun. Here are some observing tips for Mercury and Venus. First of all, never scan the sky unless the Sun is completely below the horizon. There's a real danger that it can cause blindness. It's really worthwhile to try and see Mercury. In fact, many astronomers never get to see Mercury in their entire lives because it's always so low on the horizon and it's always there for such a short time. Especially if you live in a city, it can be difficult to get a clear horizon. To be aware of is that neither Venus nor Mercury will be colourful targets. They'll be bright, but there isn't actually much surface detail to see. The maximum elongation you get to see for Mercury is between 18 to 28 degrees, and for Venus is between 45 to 47. Though Venus and Mercury are low on the horizon, you're always going to be affected, the image is always going to be affected by atmospheric dispersion. So there are several ways you can get around this. You can try an atmospheric dispersion corrector, which is a series of prisms that you can align to counteract the movements of the atmosphere. Another way is to use a red filter, which will block out the worst light that is affected by atmospheric dispersion, which is the blue especially. Another way is to use a IR filter if you're doing astrophotography. However, if you are trying to capture the clouds of Venus, a blue filter is actually quite useful because blue brings out the details more on the clouds of Venus. That's all for another episode. Give us a like if you like the episode, comment if you've got any questions, and please subscribe for more astronomy videos.